During a recent event, Republican Senate candidate Herschel Walker somehow managed to compare himself to Jesus Christ and then suggested that Jesus also had a mental disorder. So here is Herschel Walker explaining all this, hopefully better than I just did, although it's Herschel Walker, so he probably isn't. But anyway, listen to Herschel Walker and his thoughts on Jesus and how he is like Jesus. Here it is.
And Jesus forgave, and what's so great about it, when Jesus was headed to the cross, when he was bearing his cross, think of every angel in heaven was so upset with us down here, what we were doing to the Holy One. They could have came down here and destroyed us all, and Jesus said, no, I got this. And he sacrificed for us, and that's what I said. That is the ultimate, ultimate price anyone can pay.
Amen.
And I remember after I left the hospital, Pastor Tony Evans is my pastor that was in Dallas, and
yeah,
he had me
man.
To speak in front of 1,500 ministers. And I told them, I said, I'm never going through anything my Holy Father hadn't gone through. And I said, if I have a mental problem, Jesus Christ must have a mental problem. And they ain't like that. And because, you know, they got their doctorate as well. And, you know, I do have an honorary doctorate, which is the same thing, I reckon. But anyway, they told me you have to suffer trauma to go through mental problems. I said, Jesus Christ was nailed to a cross. Is that not a lot of trauma? So I said, there's nothing that you're going to go through that Jesus hadn't gone through.
So Herschel Walker says, if I have a mental problem, then Jesus Christ has a mental problem. Now, in the Bible, there's no indication that Jesus had mental health issues. Maybe they left it out. I don't know. I wasn't there. But for Herschel Walker, there is actually a book that details his fight with mental illness. A book that he himself wrote about having dissociative identity disorder. So Herschel Walker has openly admitted that he does have mental health problems. So when he says, if I have them, then Jesus has them, well, we know he has them. So he is saying that Jesus has mental health problems flat out. Now, Herschel Walker's mental health issues, right? The dissociative identity disorder should not in and of itself exclude him from holding public office. What should exclude him from holding office is that his particular affliction leads him to fits of violence and rage. And that, of course, is coming from his ex-wife, who at one point claims that Herschel Walker threatened to murder her. A claim, by the way, that Herschel Walker does not deny. He says, I'm glad that this information is now out here, because it came out just a couple weeks ago. I'm glad it's out there, you know, so people can see that I'm not like that. But we have no proof that you're not like that anymore. You know, forget for a moment all the sentences you attempted to string together in that clip that made absolutely no sense. Forget for a moment the fact that you compared your honorary PhD to actual real doctors saying it's pretty much the same thing. Maybe it was a joke, maybe it wasn't. But either way, it's the violence in Herschel Walker's history that raises the biggest red flags. And here he is trying to compare himself to Jesus. Now, as far as we know, there was one fit of rage from Jesus in the Bible, and that's when he kicked the money changers out of the temple. Jesus never held a gun to somebody's head and said, I'm going to blow your brains out, which is, according to his ex-wife, what Herschel Walker did. So not only is he committing blasphemy, but he's also trying to downplay the severity of his condition. This man is a danger. He's a danger for so many reasons. His history alone is telling us that. And unfortunately, he's trying to play that up as a strength rather than something that he should be getting help for. That's what we should be doing. I know it's fun to sit here and mock Herschel Walker for being probably one of the dumbest people to ever run for office, But at the same time, we've also seen this man go through many a mental health crisis. And the question I have is he getting the help that he needs? Right? His condition that he admits that he has is not something that you just wake up one day and you're cured. Okay, this is something you have to work on forever. And as far as I can tell, it doesn't seem like he's doing that, which is what makes him so dangerous because he is prone to those fits of violence and rage. And for the record, no, Jesus was not.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.